Good morning and welcome back to St Mary's Church Newmarket on this, the third Sunday of Lent. We have had time now to begin our Lenten disciplines, our fasting, our study of the scriptures. And hopefully over the period of Lent, we've had the opportunity to learn more about God's will for us, God's will for his world. And those Lenten disciplines are helping us to do that. Next week is the fourth Sunday of Lent, is Mothering Sunday, and there'll be more on that next week. But in today's Mass, we bless a new set of vestments which have been donated in memory of somebody who worshipped here for a long time. They are rose-coloured, and that symbolises the lightening of the Lenten discipline, the lightening of the Lenten tone. The violet becomes a much lighter shade of rose. It reminds us that in the midst of our sorrow and penitence, God still wants us to feel his joy, his love, his comfort. And you'll see those themes of joy, of comfort, of refreshment from the Lenten disciplines come through in the blessing that we use in the Mass. So before the final blessing, it gives us great pleasure to be able to bless a new set of vestments which will be used for the first time next week. These are rose in colour, we say, they're pink. They're used on the fourth Sunday of Lent and the third Sunday of Advent to lighten the violet shade. It's the time to reflect that even in the midst of our penitence and our turning back to God, God refreshes us, God gives us his hope and his joy, and this should be a time of joy. The psalm set for next Sunday morning should be Psalm 23. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, yet will I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. So these have been very kindly donated in memory of Mary Wiseman by Janet. So these are for our use, I say, in Lent and in Advent. God of love and compassion, who for us who are weary and heavy laden, offer an easy yoke and burden light, in your mercy, bless these rose-coloured vestments of priest and altar, that both they may be for us, your faithful people, in the midst of our sorrow and repentance, signs of your everlasting loving kindness and mercy towards us. We who by the use of this chasuble, remembering that you call us to take up our cross, receive the grace to so take it that we may merit what it promises. Who by the use of this stole, recalling our unworthiness to stand in your presence, attain to the eternal joys of your salvation. We who by the use of this veil, being sheltered from those things which we cannot comprehend, discern with your wisdom the mysteries of our life in your spirit. We who by the use of this verse, being kept pure from all defilement, are brought at the last to stand with saints and angels, praising you on high. And that also our humble offerings, made to your unending glory and in memory of those who have gone before us in the faith, may always be found acceptable in your sight. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
I thought this might be a good opportunity to show you some of the things we use during the liturgy of the Mass. These are the new vestments which were blessed this morning. They're not new vestments, they are new to us. They're pre-loved, as we say these days. Now, when blessing things ought not to be blessed twice for the same purpose, but because these are new to us, because they are being put to new use, it's appropriate to bless them again for that purpose. So these are the vestments of the priest. These are what the priest would wear. First we have the stole, which is a long, thin piece of cloth, a scarf, if you like, which is usually embroidered with a cross at the nape and at the ends. It's laid out here in the alpha shape, the A, the first letter of the Greek alphabet, and Christ is the beginning and the end. The stole would often be accompanied by a girdle laid out in an omega shape. So that would be worn around the neck. The priest would kiss the cross at the nape and then place it around the neck. That would be followed by the chasuble here, which, as you can see, matches the stole in its design. It has a yoke printed on it, the Y shape, and the prayer that's often used when vesting in the chasuble talks about the yoke of Christ, the burden that he places on us all when we take up our cross and follow him. That during this season of Lent is something we are reflecting on as we are called to follow the way of the cross and all that that means. So the chasuble is the outermost garment. It's worn over the top of all the other vestments at the Mass. You can see here it shows a design which is Eucharistic in nature. Not only does it show the chalice and the host, but it shows the word eke, behold. That's the word used at the Mass when the priest holds up the consecrated bread and wine and says, behold the Lamb of God, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Those are the vestments of the priest. These are sometimes called the vestments of the altar. These are the burse and veil. These would dress the chalice, the cup that's used to hold the wine, the paten, the plate on which would be placed the bread, the pall, which covers the paten and the chalice, pall being a word used in funeral liturgies for a covering over the coffin. The same word is being used here for something which covers those elements which participate in the death of Christ, that when they are offered to us, we may participate in his death and in his risen life. There might also be a ciborium, a place where bread is kept, so a ciborium and a chalice. They would be dressed with the veil, which, as you can see, matches the chasuble and the stole in this case in the design, and the cross placed on the front, and the burse, which contains the corporal, which would be laid out at the start of the liturgy underneath a sort of tablecloth or napkin on which stand all the other elements of the liturgy. The Lord be with you. Now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.